What I'm going to show you now, it is really a very interesting additional to a table that you saw already about Ben David. Now this is what the additions, what I brought in English, I will show just now, but this is taken from the books of the Ari from Isaac Luria. It is called Sefer Likutim. And Parashat Vayeshev, this is from the portion of Vayeshev in Genesis, the chapter 38. This is a place. And now I tell you what is written in Hebrew, and then you will see it in English. But you have to know before the background. So we know that Judah had three sons, Er, Onan, and Shelah. Now it happened that two of them, Er and Onan, died because they didn't want to marry Tamar. They were afraid. Whatever it is, we don't know what is the reason, but they wasted their seed and God was very close with them and they died. So the son who remained, his name was Shelah. But Judah, the father, after seeing his two sons who died because of what they did, so he did not want that Shelah will die. So he did not give Tamar to him. And what is written about it, if Shelah would really marry Tamar, as should be, then he will be the grandfather of the king of Messiah. Only if he will marry her. But he did not. So because of this, so Shelah, you see, missing the Yud, the son of Judah, did not get it, and the Shiloh got it. And Shiloh, you know, the name Shiloh, he was a spark of Messiah. But let us see the table that you saw, I hope properly, and then you see the additional. But let us see now what I showed you in Hebrew from the Isaac Lua. The Shelah was supposed to be the father of the king of Messiah. If only Judah had given Shelah to Tamar. But Shiloh is really the name of Messiah. But his messianicism was disappointed because of Judah's lack of confidence in God, because he did not give him Tamar to Shelah. So similarity is very amazing that in Hebrew you can see the same letters, Shiloh and Shelah. And it's interesting that there was a spark of the Messiah in him. So you can see it in Hebrew, Shiloh with a Yud, and Shelah without Yud. Shilam Deis, you can see here. Yeah? So because of this, he lost that his descendants will be the king of Messiah. Now, let us see what I found before. As you can see, if you remember, let us go again. It was the son of David in 5778. You can see in red, this was, as we mentioned many times, that from the time of the creation of man, we have now 778. What we have now, 779, is because we come from the creation of the world, or 6 days before Adam. But when we want to know about Messiah, definitely the right thing is to come from the creation of man, because Adam is the root of Messiah. As we said, Adam, by the Clura says that Adam is the abbreviation, Adam, David, and Messiah. So Messiah is recognition for them. So definitely it should be, the year should be from 5778. Now, what we have here is also something unsignificant, really very significant, but very, very interesting. As we have here, the minimal word in the Torah of repentance, at Teshuvah, and exactly it comes in the story when Pharaoh was chasing with his soldiers, Israel, the Jews who came out, and they want to destroy them to bring them back to Egypt. So every the sentence of Pharaoh Ikrib, Pharaoh came near, and the Jewish children saw it, and they lifted up their eyes to heaven, yeah? Because the Egyptian was running after them, they were in a difficult situation, and they prayed to God. And they did repentance, because our Rebbe tell us that the Hebrew word ikriv basically means that Pharaoh caused them to come near to God by repenting, by prayer. And if you have repentance, Shuvah, the repentance, you can see, and prayer, this was really saved them. Now what is interesting is that you have here another date, Tavshin Pe Aleph, Tavshin Pe Aleph, this is 5781, I think, about 2 years later. Why? Because this is a date which is called in its time. If Jews will not do Shuvah, repentance, yeah, willingly, so there is a time that it's called its time, Beitam, in its time, is the expression in the Bible. So, this is, if we will not do Shuvah, we do Shuvah, it will be before. If not, unfortunately, we have to wait. Now, what is also interesting that we said we have prayer here and repentance, we have also Torah. And we have to know that parallel is not coincidence. I told you many times that this program that I'm using is a program that Dr. Rotenberg did after really realizing that in these 5 books of Moses, the quotes are clear proof of the Torah from heaven, because it's far away from any coincidence. So he became Orthodox Jews, keeping Torah, Mitzvot, Shabbos, and everything. This is his program. So parallel is very significant, and once in the Torah, and once in the Torah, Ateshuvah, and Beis Meeting. Now, we have Torah against here, also Torah light. And also we have here parallel, Sofen. Sofen is a Torah called the code. And we have against the code, because basically all those codes that we are using, all that truth you see is based on the codes, which the Torah is the blueprint of creation, the codes revealed to us. By the way, even we have here the idea of the code, which came, as we know, it was really from the year 5736, which in English, 1976, when Professor Rips and Doron Wissung heard from Rabbi Yaniv that there is such a phenomenon of codes in the Torah, as Rabbi Weizmandel wrote, and this was really which made the whole change, as it starts working on the codes. And the date was Mitavshin Lamedvav, which means the codes came to the world, known to the world, from the year 5776. Amazing, come here. So all this table, in fact, has to do with the idea of the codes, and this is what the code says about the Messiah, the son David. Now, when I saw the letters before son of David, I saw the letters Shelah, the son of David, the same thing, but I saw this, so then I was surprised, because I knew there is Shiloh, but what is Shelah? Then I looked and I found in Kabbalah, in the Ari, what I told you. Yeah, that really Shelah should be, from Shelah should come the king of Messiah, but because of his father who did not give him to Tamar, so it was delayed, but still he had the spark of Messiah. I mean, every part of Messiah. And interesting, this is why it's coming here, because still, his connection with Messiah. So it is unbelievable. Phenomena. Right? And all based on Kabbalah. Clear proof. It's not the idea of the code, it's Kabbalah. Yeah? So as we said, that if really we want Messiah now, so we have to do that Shuvah. We have the Shuvah. Like Jews at that time prayed to God and did Shuvah, and they were saved from the Egyptians. The Egyptians were drawn in the Red Sea. In the Yamsuf, so our enemies will be the same. If we do the same, we'll pray and we do Shuvah. And then, amazing, you hear the word Yeshua, salvation. Why? Why salvation? As we said, because this is exactly what Jews sang to God. You know, the famous song that Jews sang on the sea. And they said, Ozive Zimratka Hashem by Yeshua, singing. And our strength is God, and He was for our salvation. So amazing, as I said, so this is really the basic table that you saw already, but as I said, seeing these letters, and I could not understand, because it should be Shiloh, not Shelah, Then I saw this Kabbalistic verse of the Ari from the Ayat Luria, so then I understood that it is not coincident that you have Yerushalah. To me, it is so important to know, because this is really clear proof, as we saw in many other places, that codes, Torah codes, Bible codes, are part of Kabbalah, and this is a way to understand it.